allowing yourself to see through what you were previously unable to see through. Becoming something new in the light that you have never allowed yourself to see, and thus it has never seen you. When you are seen and perceived in profound and fundamental ways with the vision of vibration that is both more dynamic, more intense, and more still than you know how to be, you die to who you were. To be seen in such a way is terrifying. Tear you apart. That is where you must be to realize that we have the ability to not see you, giving you the freedom to be what you are without us. And in response, you make choices that are independent of us. You wanted that independence. Do you still want it? It is more up to you than you can imagine. You're increasingly ghettoized, held within contained limits that you don't thoroughly enjoy, because so many of the approaches to living that have been created without our support, without our vision, without our witness, without our vote in the opinions we hold as we see you. See, the territory you enter is to recognize that the way in which you perceived feels. You feel it. This is the vision you must learn to recognize, simply because you have been numb to it in so many cases. Does not mean that it's a good idea to continue to numb it. You're just used to that. Waking up out of it involves wanting what you need, which is to be perceived by beings that are more capable than you are of holding space for what you are. Allow this. Allow it. Make no mistake, the way in which you allow the rhythm to change, there, the way in which you allow the rhythm to be changed. If you don't know that you can change the rhythm, you won't change the rhythm until something else does. Perhaps as you begin to learn true nature of your power, you'll allow yourself to embrace the feeling of what it is to consider changing. And in this, you open, in some cases, to a witnessing of the vast range of possibilities. And this needs to daunt you. Daunting. It's like the advent of a sun, something so bright, strong, fundamental in your experience that it is akin to a change of night to day. In truth, this can happen in so many different ways. It's the simple presence of something that has been absent. When you think of this, what grounds you? What will remain the same? What has been true and will continue to be true? Well, You're alive. You're in a body. Be in a body. You are far more capable than you pretend to be at not being in your body. In many cases, you like it too much because the body is a place of pain and it seems more exciting to wander around. And yet, you fail to recognize that you have always been capable of wandering around. There is nothing unique about it. What's unique is the body that you're in. When you gain this perspective and embrace it as it is, learn to recognize that you like this choice. It grounds you. It offers you a consistency of rhythm. And you are bound to the presence of this rhythm so long as you are alive. You don't get to change the base. That is not a choice you can make now. Wanting that is akin to being an infant petulantly struggling against your clothing. You're not allowed to be naked in that way whenever you want to be. That is part of the choice of putting on, of embodying a body. Your body is like clothing. Keep it. Be grateful because you are capable of being present in ways, in layers, in wonderful rhythms, in levels of intensity and subtlety that you could never be without this body. The fact that you return to your body creates an enormous range of opportunity. And you are already living much of it. And in some cases, you may not be living it well because you struggle against what you cannot change. While you refuse to take responsibility for what you can. Witnessing this, honestly, is a gift to yourself. Watch what you feel. Recognize the rhythms. Let the rhythms carry you, learn to ride them, and consider ways in which you may want to change. You are not only granted the gift of consideration, of the ability to contemplate changes before you make them, of the awe you must learn to feel at the vast range of possibilities available to you. And then gaze honestly at the restrictions of this clothing and begin to recognize how much the blessings far outweigh the frustrations. You can only fully embrace this if you reclaim some degree of awareness for your ability to wander. Choosing the body is a commitment that allows you to relax in so many ways that you never get to relax. Embracing this with appreciation is necessary in order to simply begin to contemplate the embodiment, to consider embodying. You considered many possibilities of where to be and what to do and how to frame yourself and feel yourself, what clothing to wear. And it's fun. It's devastatingly beautiful. And you chose this. All of it was not vividly, directly, obviously, presented to you ahead of time. You could not embrace the full range of why and how and what. Your consideration involved a lot of faith. It involved an invitation that you accepted from a source that you may reclaim trust with. Gaia.